My name is Jana, and the other one is Meggan. And we met at school at the KADK, and we started to like work together there for half a year.
Yeah, and I'm Meggan, and I studied alongside Jana at KADK. And we both have a similar background in terms of working as architects in Denmark, in Copenhagen.
Copenhagen wanted to become carbon neutral by 2025. And since the CO2 emissions just from the transport sector are like 12% of the whole CO2 emissions within Copenhagen's municipality, we thought that there's a huge potential to look into that and how we can decrease those CO2 emissions for the city.
The project was looking at alternative ways of dealing with the last mile issue. So typically the last mile is the last mile within the city of where the goods are delivered to the consumer. The project focuses primarily on the least efficient and most polluting part of the journey of a package. So the idea was to take the goods from a hub, which sits on the outskirts of the city, into the infrastructure of the metro system and the tunnels, and utilizing that infrastructure to get parcels around the city, like as if it's veins in a way into the city. So for example, when you first come in to the city, you have a distribution hub where packages get dropped off by a standard truck. These enter the metro system almost like veins, where they actually relieve the pressure from the streets above. These goods are transported through the city all the way to metro stations, where they are unloaded and then often picked up by the consumer and spread out into the city.
And I think especially like when you look at Copenhagen's metro system, it's like a system which is like on development. And at the moment, there's basically from every point within the city in a 600 meter radius, you always reach a metro station, which made it kind of like a key point within the city, which was super reachable from every occasion. And also on the other hand, the metro is primarily transport means for passengers commuting to work or commuting to the city. So that means that basically there's a huge window from the morning rush hour when that is over to like the afternoon rush hour, that there's a huge time potential which can be actually used, as well as like during nighttime, which is especially when you look at logistics and how they kind of work, you kind of have a lot of deliveries going overnight, because that is the times basically where also the roads are empty and you don't have that many congestions. So the Copenhagen Metro was like the perfect solution for us, for our idea of like hacking that system and reducing the CO2 emissions. Another thing about it was that during peak hours, the metro is going like basically every 2 minutes, but during off-peak hours, it's actually only going every 4 minutes or every 8 minutes. So there is the potential to just add this extra train in between. Like that wouldn't require any more tracks or anything, because the tracks are already able to carry that throughout the day.
In order to actually get the amount of packages that we need into the city and around the city, you actually have to introduce a new, completely new parcel train that during peak time would work as a passenger train as normal. It would just have no seats. And then during off-peak hours, it would work primarily as a cargo train. So the design and everything is exactly the same as the trains we have today. It's just the seats are only the folding down seats, and you don't have the standard set seats that you have today. We actually collaborated with the metro company and we discussed this. So during peak hours, a lot of people have to stand anyway. So these trains would actually allow even more people on, because you're not using up the space for the seating. If Copenhagen really wants to become carbon neutral by 2025, this is the things that they really need to start considering. But with the likes of New York, for example, Amazon is already sending their carriers onto the subway system. And that's because they can't see another way to get to the consumer quick enough. So then the subway system is actually being exploited by Amazon already. So if you could actually get the government or the city to realise this and actually say, hey, but you can get ahead of these companies and actually implement something that is greener, they would be silly not to do it.